Oh, wait, what? No main menu. Okay.
Funtime Auditorium maintenance vent opened.
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly as possible. Proceed forward to reach the parts and service room.
The noises are terrifying. Okay, the door is just ahead of me. And as long as I don't move while it's recharging, I should be fine. You know, technically, I think I could just walk straight once I see the door once and I'd be fine. But knowing this is a Five Nights at Freddy's game, it can't be that simple. God damn it! Why? I just have a question for Scott. Why did you make part of the game complete a game series that has been known to be completely dependent on both sight and sound and completely eliminate both factors so that way it's random luck? Or at least it feels like random luck. How come I get kicked here?
Maintenance vent opened.
Foxy. Foxy's always the first one to kill me. God damn it!
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly as possible. Proceed forward to reach the parts and service room.
Yeah, use the flash beacon in order to make sure you don't bump anything, like the fucking killer robot in the room. Make me jump every time. I know it's coming. Come on, we can do this.
Funtime Auditorium maintenance vent opened.
Okay.
Unlike Ballora, Funtime Foxy is motion activated. For this reason, it's important to keep the room dark as to not accidentally activate her. You have been provided with a flash beacon. Use it if you need to get your bearings and to ensure you don't bump into anything. However, use it as sparingly as possible. Proceed forward to reach the parts and service room.
Yeah, blah blah, shut the hell up. Is there any way to mute this guy? Also, I can see my dog moving around on my bed, which is throwing me off like crazy. Okay. Foxy, Foxy, fun time, Foxy. Wait. If Foxy's motion activated, shouldn't that mean that it's also sensitive to sound? And wait, what's the excuse for these guys being on all night? I mean, originally, it was so that the parts and stuff didn't lock up. Okay. I didn't get a good picture of that, but that thing's head was moving side to side, right? I don't want to move. 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 I'm not looking at the screen. I'm not looking at the screen. Yeah, originally it was that way the servos didn't lock up. These things, I've seen the endoskeletons. There's no servos, it's basically just a giant interior muscle mass. So, why did they need to be on? I got in. Oh, thank God. If I die, do I have to do that again? Please tell me no.
Motion trigger, parts and service.
Great job reaching parts and service. It seems that Funtime Freddy is out of power, which should make your job much easier. The release switch for the chest cavity is located on the underside of the endoskeleton jaw. To reach it, we will first need to open the face plates. You will need to press the face plate release triggers in a specific order, and it's important to be as precise and as careful as possible.
Oh, good.
Locate the small button on Freddy's face, just under his right cheek, and press it.
Alright, I will, but quick question, and I have a lot of questions, the first of which being, why in the name of God are the default positions of these things with the eyes bolted open? Seriously, why don't they have eyelids that close so that way at least it looks like it's sleeping?
Great. Now locate the button under his left cheek and press it. Great.
Okay.
Now carefully locate and press the button next to Freddy's right eye.
Right eye. There it is.
Great. Now carefully locate and press the button just above Freddy's nose.
Okay. Oh, there it is. I like how these things slightly light up. Thank you, Scott. Oh! Fucking
good
Christ,
job.
Scott!
The face plates should now be open. Locate and press the small button on the underside of Freddy's endoskeleton jaw.
You mean this?
Excellent. The chest cavity should now be open. Remove the power module from the chest cavity.
What is this? Like, I get it's the endoskeleton, but why does it look like this?
Great work. You will now be required to remove the secondary power module from the Bonnie hand puppet.
Okay,
press
you...
the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power module.
Seriously gave the rabbit... a secondary power supply. Under what conditions would this be necessary? In case the bear's power supply fails? Where did the rabbit go? I know he's got like three spots he shows up in. not there. Not. Where'd he go?
Press the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power module.
Where is he? Am I gonna be murdered by a hand puppet? Well, considering the movies that I like watching, I wouldn't be surprised. Seriously, if you haven't seen them, go check out my black and white reviews of the Puppet Master movies. They're crap, but they're hilarious. God damn it, the frame rate screwed me over. I'm playing this game in between, like, 15 and 10.
Press the large black button beneath Bonnie's bow tie to release the power module.
Go on, you stupid little rabbit. And ha!
Great job. You've acquired both power modules. This completes your tasks for the night.
Awesome.
Please exit the building through Funtime Auditorium, and we'll see you back here again tomorrow.
I gotta walk through that nightmare again? Come on, just give me shift over. 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 Just give me... God damn it! I do not like green eggs and ham. Why the hell are you making me do this? It's all right. I just killed the ringleader. Everything should be okay. That was bad. 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 That thing is right in front of me, isn't it?
Daddy, she can make balloons.
What?
Have you seen her make balloons? Oh, Daddy, let me go to her.
What's going on? I died. Didn't I? I thought I died. Foxy got me.
Shh, be still and quiet.
I don't think I want to.
You've been sleeping for quite a while.
Sleeping.
I think they noticed that you never left the building last night.
Gee, I wonder why.
The cameras were searching for you, but they couldn't find you. I have you hidden too well.
Why? I'm already on night four, but I've only been playing an hour, I think. Yeah, just about an hour.
Don't be afraid.
Not.
I'm not going to hurt you.
I seriously doubt that.
I am only going to keep you for a little while. Try not to wiggle, though. You're inside something that came from my old pizzeria. I don't think it was ever used. At least not the way it was meant to be used.
Why do you talk only in ominous whispers?
It's just big enough for one person to fit inside. But just barely. You're in the scooping room. Do you know why they call it the scooping room? It's because, dummy, this is the room where they use the scooper. I thought that would be obvious.
Okay.
Isn't that a fun name for something?
Not really.
The scooper. It sounds like something you would use for ice cream.
Honest.
Or custard. Or sprinkles.
Honestly, it sounds kind of terrifying when you say it.
Birthday party. To ensure that you get a heaping portion of every good thing. I wonder, though, if you were a freshly opened pint of ice cream, how you would feel about something with that name. Thankfully, I don't think a freshly opened pint of ice cream feels anything at all. Uh-oh. It sounds like someone else is in the building. Shh.
Hey!
Forward.
Hey!
One more.
Hey!
Stop.
I'm in here!
Watch the step.
I'm in the suit!
What happened to it this time? It just seems like these things can't go a day without breaking down.
To be fair, they're made of cords.
It's always the same, man. Some kind of hardware malfunction.
Hardware.
I'll be somewhere in 15 minutes, and this place gives me the creeps.
Gives you the creeps. I work the night shift.
It's all automated. We don't have to be here for it.
Hey! Seriously? You don't notice the weird animatronic in the room that's not supposed to be here. God, that's loud. I think even in audio testing that's gonna be loud. Jeez. I'd be surprised if that doesn't come through the microphones. And... hi, Ballora. I don't know why, but Scott seems to really like you. Creepy.
There's something very important that I've learned how to do over time. Do you know what that is?
Die?
How to pretend. Do you ever play make-believe? Pretend to be one way, when you are really the other?
Yes.
It's very important. Ballora never learns, but I do.
Creepy.
They think there is something wrong on the inside. The only thing that matters is knowing how to pretend.
Why are you so creepy? Wait, what? What? What's going on? I like those noises. Ow!
I'll open the faceplates for you. That way they can find you on the cameras. Now, all you have to do is wait. I'd recommend that you keep the spring locks wound up. Your breathing and your heartbeat are causing them to come loose. You don't want them to get too loose. Trust me.
Okay, there are lots of things I would love to do to you, sweetie. Trust is not one of those. God, can you imagine what would happen if that was a human being in there? What the hell? Hey, get the hell up. I can't wind these things! Actually, how am I winding these things? And why is there a Springlock suit here that was used at Fazbear's? And why are Ballora's little minions all in here? Okay, that's gonna prove to be difficult. I can already tell that with the low frame rate that I have. Fantastic. Well, since this is the part everybody gets stuck on, I'm gonna leave this video here, and I'm going to just let things play out naturally once I figure out how to do this with my busted-ass frame rate. So, I will see you guys next time on Let's Play Five Nights at Freddy's Sister Location. Hopefully I can beat Night 4. Because I don't think Night 5 will be a problem, but Night 4 is going to be one hell of a bitch. Sleep tight, my Legion. I'll see you next time.